Hey guys and girls, this is Götz von Behringer. This is the System 55, our new Eurek-compatible modular synthesizer. And these modules are, of course, authentic reproductions of the 55, 35 and 15 series of the 1960s and 70s. Now in this video, I want to chat about what this authentic actually means, where the differences and the similarities to Eurek are. So if you just want a quick overview of the system or maybe a video on an individual module, click here or check out the System 55 playlist in the description. But if you don't mind me rambling about nitty-gritty technical details and slightly nerdy stuff, then just keep watching. So, what is authentic? Well, back in the early days, in our case in the early to mid 60s, electronic circuits were constantly changing and evolving. And that means if you're taking multiple devices of the same model, maybe throw a couple of schematics within the mix, that all of them will be slightly different. Simply because everything was so new, it was constantly changed and constantly being refined. Our module specifically reproduces the very, very early circuitry, because this gives you more coloration, more distortion, more harmonic content, and more of that perfect, non-perfect vintage sound. It also means that some modules at some certain settings might be a bit quirky, but I mean, that's the fun of it all. Let's be discreet. Now, one of the most common things you'll find in electronics is the so-called op-amp. And the op-amp is a circuit within the circuit, and among other things, it amplifies a signal. So you will find an op-amp in every EQ, in every filter, in every VCA. And since the modern days, let's say the early 80s, these op-amps are shrunken down and integrated as a circuit on these little chips. This is why these chips are called ICs, integrated circuits. And these are great. They are low noise, low distortion, and so forth. But of course, this is not what we want. And this is why the System 55 modules have almost no op-amps built them. They're completely built from discrete parts. And discrete means made of individual parts, no chips. And again, this is not only historically correct, but it also gives you this historically correct sound. A good example would be the 902 VCA. At low levels, it sounds super nice and clean, but if you push it, it can really get dirty. Eurek power is plus 12 and minus 12 volts. This is what you're connecting internally to the connector on the module. Our System 55 modules run on plus 12 and minus 6 volts. You don't have to think about it. The conversion happens on the module itself. Just connect it to a Eurek case and you're ready to go. And again, this is not only because it's historically accurate, but it's also because it influences the sound. Lower voltage means lower headroom, and lower headroom means it's easier to overdrive a signal. It's easier to get into harmonic distortion. Good example would be the mixer module. On the mixer module, you will see even asymmetrical clipping, meaning that the lower part of the waveform will clip before the higher part of the waveform. And again, this gives you this very, very specific and authentic sound. Speaking of Eurek, all the System 55 modules are 100% Eurek compatible. So if you want to use them in a mixed setup, just build them in and use them. The audio might be a tiny bit more quiet, but that's not a problem. You just boost the signal at a later stage. Then sometimes you might notice that certain labels are a bit unusual. For example, on the filter, it says regeneration, and that's just another name for the resonance. Or on the sequencer module, it says oscillator. An oscillator on a sequencer, that's kind of unusual. Technically, it is an oscillator, but nowadays you just would print tempo on the front panel. So no problem, just a different name. And you've guessed it, it's historically accurate. There are a couple of modules who might need, let's call it a companion. To use one or more of the 921B oscillators, you need a 921A oscillator driver. And one driver can control up to 12 oscillators. If you just want a single oscillator, go for the 921. The 960 sequencer works great standalone, but you might want to add the 962 sequential switch, because the switch turns the sequencer from an 8-step sequencer into a 24-step sequencer. Only the 911 envelope generator and the 911A trigger delay, they don't function standalone. These need a 961 interface module, because here we are dealing with V trigger and S trigger. Now, triggers are what we would call gates today. And the triggers or gates are on-off events. For example, pressing a key and releasing a key. And the V-trigger is 100% compatible with Eurorack. For example, the sequencer outputs V-trigger, and therefore you can connect it to the Neutron or any other third-party Eurorack module. S-triggers, on the other hand, are not Eurorack compatible, but they are only used in two modules, in the envelope generator and in the dual trigger delay. So if you want to use these two modules in a either mixed setup or in a pure System 55 setup, you would also need the interface module. And the interface module can convert from S-trigger to V-trigger and the other way around, and can even generate V-triggers from an audio signal. Now, why? Again, we really wanted to honor the historic circuitry and wanted to be as authentic as possible. And today you still get a nice benefit from the S-trigger input, because you can connect a passive foot switch and use it to generate a trigger signal. By the way, the S-trigger historically was used to connect the keyboards. I hope this video gave you an insight about the circuitry of the System 55 and showed you that we really respectfully recreated this historic circuit, including unbuffered multiples, passive attenuators, and so on. And as always, if you have questions or feedback, please put them in the comments, like and subscribe, and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.